to.
To be loved, but only by you. I shouldn't be so crazy about you, but what could I do? This feeling has me sighing. My dreams, you're magnifying. Big Band Jazz. That's my buddy Billy Vera with I Want to Be Loved. And before him was Duke Ellington with Coco from the Essential Duke Ellington Collection from 1958. Music continues here on K-Jazz right after the break with Allison Adams Tucker. She got the world on a string.
You listen to K-Jazz throughout the year, so spread your pledge out the same way. Try K-Jazz FM's monthly sustainer plan. It's a modest amount billed to your credit card every month, so your contribution keeps giving all year, and the sustaining membership renews automatically. To become a sustainer, go to jazzandblues.org.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Chair Machen.
Here.
Commissioner Aguilar.
Here.
Vice Chair Thomas.
Here.
Commissioner Campbell.
Here.
Commissioner Klinger. Commissioner Klinger is absent.
Thank you. All right. By motion of the Planning Commission, this is the time to notify the public of any changes to the agenda, rearrange the order of the agenda, and provide an opportunity for any member of the Planning Commission or staff to request an item be removed from the consent calendar for separate action. Are there any changes to the agenda?
There are no changes.
Can we have a motion to accept the agenda as presented?
Move to accept.
Second.
Vote, please. All right, we have four in favor. Motion passes.
Mr.
At this time, members of the public may address the Planning Commission regarding any items within the subject jurisdiction matter of the Commission. Pursuant to the Brown Act, the Commission cannot discuss or take action on any items not on the agenda unless authorized by law. Those members of the public wishing to speak are asked to come forward to the microphone, state their name for the record. All speakers will be limited to a period of 5 minutes. Public hearing is now open.
Good evening. Thank you for this opportunity. What I'm going to discuss or talk about is not on your agenda, and I know it'd be more appropriate for me to go to the city council meeting, but I'm out of town this week and I can't. I'm a little late to the game, but I just want to lend my support to the LA Fitness.
Excuse me, can you state your name?
Oh, I'm Shannon Brennan, and I live in Leisure World. I'm one of the 9,000 people in Leisure World, and I'm one of the many people in Leisure World that's very concerned with fitness and health. We have a great gym. It's a very small gym. We've got a pool. It's a very small pool. I don't want to go through all of the reasons I've got for fitness. Everyone knows those. What I want to stress is what a benefit it would be to the people in Leisure World. I'm going to turn 65 in December. I'll be on Medicare. And as part of my Kaiser Senior Advantage, because I'm going to stay with Kaiser, I will be able to have silver sneakers. Silver sneakers will allow me to join LA Fitness at no cost. I know that there are several people in Leisure World, many, many people in Leisure World, that will take advantage of LA Fitness. I think it would be good for the 9,000 voters that live in Leisure World. We're one-third of the city of Seal Beach. I think it would be good for the community in general. I understand that there is a contingent of people that are unhappy with the proposed plan because of traffic and safety issues. I can tell you that most of the people in Leisure World and me 15 years from now will not contribute to the traffic problem. I'll take the shuttle from Leisure World and shop at Sprouts. Well, go to the gym, then shop at Sprouts and take the shuttle back. It would just be really good for Seal Beach to encourage business. It'll be good for Seal Beach to allow a business owner to do what they want with their own property. It will be good for the children of Seal Beach. They'll be able to join the gym too. It'll maybe, if there is a traffic problem, I looked at the map of Rossmore. They seem to be the people that have the biggest issue with it. There's four elementary schools in Rossmore. I don't think you could live anywhere in Rossmore where you're not more than two or three blocks from an elementary school. Why are people driving their kids to school? Why aren't you walking your kids to school? And if there is a traffic problem, maybe they can walk their kids to school and everyone will be healthier. We'll be healthier, those of us that join the gym, and they'll be healthier when they decide to not get in those gas-guzzling cars and drive their children to school. So, I guess that's it. It's not my whole 5 minutes, but thank you so much for listening.
Thank you. Before anyone else comes up, I just want to remind everyone, as she did mention, it's not the LA Fitness is not on our agenda tonight. It will be coming before the EQCB on Wednesday at 6 p.m., just so that you know. And also, I just want to let you know that none of us can comment at all or discuss anything that's not on the agenda. But you're welcome to speak on it if you'd like to tonight. You'll need to come.
Uh, I'm David Powell. I live in a different mutual than she lives in Leisure World. So you can't comment just tonight or any time on this issue.
We can't comment at any time on anything that's not on the agenda for that evening.
Mm-hmm. But as far as phone calls or email contact during the week, then
absolutely.
That's okay or not?
Madam Chair, may I address the question?
Yes.
That's a public hearing item, so the time to present your testimony is during the public hearing at the Planning Commission when it comes before the Planning Commission, and I don't know if there's a date yet.
We're expecting it in May sometime, possibly.
Okay, so if you have comments that you want to submit, you can submit them in writing beforehand, and they'll be part of what the commissioners get, or you can do both. You can come to the commission meeting and present your testimony like you're doing tonight. But anything, it's not on the agenda tonight. The Brown Act doesn't allow the commissioners to comment on it at all. And any evidence that you have, anything you want to present, needs to be presented at the public hearing. Because anything you want the commission as a body to consider has to be presented at the public hearing.
Okay, so no open discussion by telephone.
I'm not going to tell you you can't contact somebody, but if you want if you feel you have evidence that is relevant to a decision, then we would strongly recommend that you come to the meeting and present it on the record so it's in the record.
I understand.
Okay.
Okay, so this is just one way tonight. I'm talking to you. You don't respond to me. So one of my main issues with wanting this project to be approved is because, as far as I've seen, it's already was disapproved once. Maybe that's not the technical term for it. But I think a lot of consideration, way too much consideration, was given to a small, very vocal group. And a big contingent of that group is not, and we're not, citizens of Seal Beach, as in Rossmore, as we all know. And yet it seems to have really affected city council vote. And I'm just asking that this commission and the city consider the 9,000 people, 1/3 of the city that are in Leisure World, and the rest of the city have senior citizens and people that whose quality of life can be greatly improved by that LA Fitness Center being there. Personally, I joined LA Fitness in 1987. I've been a dues-paying member and attending 30 years now. I think it's a good thing. It's a good thing for the city. It's a good thing for the local community. As I presume you know by now, the 9 big box stores in that shopping center have agreed that it's a good thing for the shopping center. Evidently, they had a legal recourse to deny the process, but they're behind it. It's good business. Business is good. When the opposing people chant no more traffic, I translate that into no more business. Traffic and business go together. It's a good thing. That's a great shopping center. People love it. Yeah. So you get traffic. People go there. It's called business. It's called bartering. You spend your money, I give it to you. We go back and forth. It really works well. It's better than shuttering things up. Specifically, LA Fitness, not being a brick and mortar retail store, won't be affected the way others in that shopping center may be as a result of internet sales. quite the opposite. People will keep going to the LA Fitness, and therefore they'll be close to those brick and mortar stores, which can keep our economy going. That's a good thing. People on the other side say that these people are only doing it because of business. They just want to make more money. I say that's a good thing. They use business as a pejorative. And then they double down on it and call them big business as a double pejorative. I simply disagree. And I'd like to see city council and the whole city to be a little more business proactive and not anti-business. I don't want to point out, well, I will point out, the Bay Theater that's kind of been there a little too long, and maybe the pier. And thank God something was done with the corner of Main Street and PCH. I'm sure that it was fought against. But I'm really for LA Fitness and for capitalism, business, and thanks for your time.
Thank you. Thank you. Anyone else for oral communications? Seeing none, oral communications is now closed. Okay. We'll move to the consent calendar and the approval of the Planning Commission meeting minutes from March 6th, 2017. Do we have a motion to approve?
I move to minutes be approved from March 6,
2017. I second.
Please vote. We have 4-4. Motion passes. And on to scheduled matters and new business. Minor use permit 17-2. Can we have a staff report, please?
Thank you, Madam Chair and fellow commissioners. Tonight I'll be presenting item 2 at 211 17th Street, minor use permit 17-2, to allow an existing duplex to remodel the front unit by altering walls along with relocating a door on the property, which is nonconforming due to parking density and setbacks within the RHD20 zoning area. The property is located on the west side of the street, 17th Street, between Electric and Landing. It has a duplex that is non-conforming, and the interior remodel requires a minor use permit approval by the commission to move forward because it is non-conforming. The front unit here is a single-story unit. And the second unit is here at the rear, which starts out here on the first floor and then goes over the garage and cantilevers over the rear of the garage. Our nonconforming sections are, one, the setbacks on the front unit here, which is only 2 foot 4 inches, and it's required to be 3 foot in this zoning area on a 25-foot wide lot as this is. The second nonconformity is the second unit. The property is only 2,500 square feet in lot size, and it's required to be 4,356 to have 2 units on it. And the third is that because we have a duplex on here, the code requires that there be 4 parking spaces within an enclosed garage. The current configuration only has a 2-car garage on it. So that's why this is non-conforming. The existing floor plan is almost going to be the same as the new floor plan. What the applicant is proposing is to take the laundry room and flip it over to this side of the residence, take the master bedroom and move it back so it can get a little bigger, and move the bathroom up towards the front right here, and then reconfigure the kitchen to make it a little larger, moving the dining room over into this area to give it the same type of floor plan. Also, We've got some doors moving along this side of the property. This door is being closed up and moved over here into the laundry room area. Also, the applicant was requesting to replace some windows on the property, but those aren't part of the minor use permit as it's not required per the code. We did not We did receive one letter of support, and you have it up on your dais this evening. It was an email asking that we approve this project. That concludes my presentation. If you have any comments, I'd be happy to answer.
Thank you. Are there any questions from the commission? All right, then we will open the public hearing. Is the applicant with us? Would you like to speak? Well, you would need to come up if that were the case.
I'm Janet Hennemark. I purchased the property last November, and at this point, I just want to reconfigure to take the bathroom out of the master bedroom so both bedrooms can share, and so reconfiguring will allow that.
Okay, are there any questions of the applicant? Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there anyone else? Mr. Eaker?
Good evening, Madam Chair, members of the Commission, staff, and the public. Seth Eaker, Old Town. A pleasure to be before you again on this kind of crisp, nice spring day. I would say that this project is very typical of a minor use permit. I know I've brought and worked with Stephen and Crystal on several of them. I think this is an excellent plan. I think it's a very clear staff report. I think that this adds utility without substantially changing the character of the building. And I think with a lot of the goals of Old Town and land use, that's what we're trying to do. So congratulations to her for buying the property and making improvements, and I fully support staff's recommendation of approval.
Thank you. Is there anyone else who would like to speak to this item? Hearing none, public hearing is closed.
Is there for approval?
I second.
Please vote. We have 4-4. Motion passes. Congratulations.
Welcome to the neighborhood.
And Madam Chair, there is a 10-day appeal period. If anyone wishes to appeal to City Council, the 10 days starts running tomorrow.
Thank you. All right. So can we have a staff report on conditional use permit 17-2, please?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Item 3 this evening is at 1011 Electric Avenue for conditional use permit 17-2 to allow the interior remodel and a addition of a second story on an existing single-family resident on a property that's non-conforming due to setbacks in the residential high-density area, RHD 20. The project is located on Electric Avenue across from the Greenbelt in between 10th and 11th Street. It's a single-family residence with a non-conforming garage that has about a one-foot setback from the side property line, and it's a detached structure. Any square footage that's added to a non-conforming structure per our code requires approval of a CUP or conditional use permit by the Planning Commission. Because this is a single-family residence, if it was a multifamily residence as the previous application, it wouldn't be allowed to add any square footage. And because the non-conforming structure is detached from the portion that's being altered, that's another reason why we can move forward with the conditional use permit. The portion here in red is the portion that's non-conforming. This is the garage at the rear of the property near the alley. So this line right here represents the required setback. So it encroaches into this area and into this back setback area on this portion. This along here is the single family residence, which they are reconfiguring the interior and adding a second story. As you can see, the second story of this residence is going to be in a wood style siding to still give it somewhat of a beach feel. It has a balcony on the front, which is in character with most of the residences here in the Old Town area, and it meets the height requirement. With that, we have received no correspondence from the legal notices, and with that, that concludes my presentation. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer.
Thank you. Does the commission have any questions of staff? Okay. Then we will open the public hearing. Is the applicant here? Would you like to approach the podium?
Hi, I am Steve Senekoff. I'm the architect for the project. As Steve said in his opening, the house, the remodel fits all codes. For what we're doing, adding the second floor, our setbacks are correct, our height limit, we're under the height limit, we're under the floor area ratio and everything. It's the existing garage is what's giving us the little bit of trouble. The style, the character, it's kind of a beachy style, and I think it fits really well with Seal Beach. And I'm here to answer any questions if anything comes up.
Thank you. If you could hold just a moment. And do we have any questions of the applicant?
It's lovely.
Thank you.
I've had two great remodels here tonight.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks.
Is there anyone else who would like to speak to this item?
Good evening. My name is Tom Quinn. I am the neighbor of this residence. And I just want to clarify one thing that seems to be written and has been orally communicated, and that is that the garage itself will not be changed in any way, shape, or form. Is that correct?
Can I answer that?
Sure.
That is correct. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else? Seth?
Seth Eager, Old Town, once again, a brief pleasure to be before you. So I think there are a couple of things I want to specifically highlight about this project. Number one, I think, again, it fits well within the character, style, and intent of Seal Beach, particularly the Old Town community. You know, originally I looked at this and I thought, wow, 743 square feet, that seems like a lot. But then when I kind of looked at it, I talked to Chairwoman Mashton a little bit about the project, and I want to compliment the architect and the family because I think it makes the home, again, more functional without necessarily creating greater impacts in our community that would be negative. And I think it's an addition, and again, congratulations, beautiful project. It's nice, once again, I think this is the third meeting, and I feel like we're just flying through beautiful projects quickly. It's an absolute delight.
Thank you. Would anyone else like to speak to this project? All right. Seeing none, public hearing is closed. And any discussion?
Move for approval.
Do we have a second?
Yeah, go ahead, Robert.
All right, I'll second that. Good.
Please vote. We have.
Wait, this fucking light. Do it again?
Do we have to vote again?
Yeah. You
vote again.
You moved the vote, that's why.
I'll vote again. Go.
We have 4.3. Motion passes.
It's a lovely house.
She's ancient.
Okay. And again, Madam Chair, there's a 10-day appeal period. If anybody wishes to appeal, that appeal period starts running tomorrow. Thank you. All right. Do we have a director's report?
There are no items.
Any commission concerns, questions? It's your lucky night.
We've been pretty good a couple weeks in a row,
actually. We adjourned the Planning Commission meeting to Monday, April 17th.
Do we approve the minutes? So?
We approve them?
No, I just canceled.
It'll
that
be canceled.
Been canceled.
Yeah. Okay.
See you in
to another time. Mm-hmm.
All right. Thank you, Deb. You know what? I fairly enjoy that. And I'm even like.
Juke joint. That was Quincy Jones again and Phil Collins.